بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. فما بعد، my brothers and sisters, there is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, somebody, some entity, think about this and say, who did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call his ni'mat? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us many ni'mat. Our life itself is a ni'mah, iman is a ni'mah, the Quran al-Kareem is a ni'mah, parents are ni'mah, children are ni'mat. The ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be counted. وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if you want to count the ni'mat of Allah, you will not be able to count them. But there is one that Allah specifically mentioned and called his ni'mah. I'm standing here with the Atlantic behind me, and in Maine, the sea is cold, the water is cold, and in front of me there are plovers which are running in the soil. You can actually see them behind me. If you see the little birds which are running, catching waders, looking at the, catching the little shellfish which they are trying to get. And there's a seagull there who's also looking for shellfish. And in this, all of this, I'm thinking, who did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call his ni'mah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, which means, verily and truly and surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his ni'mah, sent his blessing on the believers in the form of his Rasul, that he created from them, that he sent to them, that he raised from among them, his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is one of them from among them. So there is a two-in-one blessing. One is the Rasul himself, that he was sent, and secondly, that the Rasul is one of us, from us. And he said, Mumineen, so he's not talking about the Arabs alone. Of course, the Mukhatib of the ayat are the Sahaba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but inshallah, we'll musta'an. This applies to all the believers in the world until the end of time. We are the people of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And then of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the work of the Nabi alayhi salam, where he said, يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, that he recites for you the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he purifies you, that he explains the ayat and teaches the ayat, and he teaches the hikmah, the meaning behind it, which is how to implement them in your life. And then Allah said that before this time, they were misguided. People were misguided before the coming of Rasulullah. I want to emphasize this point very, very much, as strongly to the best of my ability as I can on myself and you. Always to have the waqar and the dignity of Rasulullah in our hearts, and on our tongues, and in our attitudes to Rasulullah. Never ever take the name of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, without saying peace and blessings be upon him. Even if you are speaking to other people who are not Muslim, say Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him. Never be in a big hurry to try to please people by just saying Muhammad or just saying Rasulullah. Na'udhu billah, always say the messenger of Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may peace and blessings be upon him. Make this something which is part of your speech as a Muslim, as somebody who loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalal who loved, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored us by sending him among us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this and reiterated this and said that this is my ni'mah on you. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu to fill your hearts with the love and the hub of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalaluhu, and to decree that on the day of judgment that you will meet him at his hawd and receive the water of Al-Kawthar from his blessed hand, inshallah. وصلى الله على النبي الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.